Welcome back to the podcast. I'm Gabe, and I'm here with...
Kate.
Sadly, Zack and Laura Shaw cannot join us today, but we're still going to move on through our day. Today, we read Act 3 of The Crucible, and we're here to talk about it.
Yo, it's me, Zack. I'm going to give you guys a summary for Act 3 of The Crucible. So basically, you know, we start off in court, because all the girls have been accused of witchcraft. Although many of the townspeople of Salem begin to argue about the true meaning of these witch hunts, like Giles Corey, he thinks it's just for land and such. John Proctor and Mary Warren enter the room, and Mary Warren claims that all the girls were faking their afflictions, and they were not caused by witchcraft. You know, and as the people are, you know, talking about this, then we find out that Elizabeth Proctor is pregnant, and she will not be killed until she births her child, which is believed to be John Proctor's, but we're not really sure about that yet. Could be someone else. That'd be pretty crazy. Judge Danforth, then he starts putting pressure on the girls, see if they're really faking or not, does not come to a solid conclusion until later. Then Proctor admits his affair with Abigail in front of everybody. It's crazy. Everyone's yelling. And after that, all the girls put on a huge stunt, pretending to be Mary's spirit. And then they all begin to scream and yell, and chaos erupts. And then, you know, the act ends. And that's the end.
Pirates, just now showing your heads? Have you been spending all this time scrubbing the village?
Luffy. Didn't you say earlier that your punches were stronger than pistols?
Shut your mouth!
Listen, I don't know what you think you're doing here, but you might want to leave. You wouldn't want something bad to happen, and I have just the man to deliver this message.
I'll blow your head off if I have to, but that's up to you, my friend.
Would you risk your life?
Now that you've drawn your pistol, are you willing to use it?
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm saying that guns aren't for threats, they're for actions.
Yep, thank you for that answer, Zack. The whole summarize of the Act 3, and we appreciate it. Now, Kate, okay, we got some questions for you about, well, the Crucible, so let's move on.
The question is, what does Hale mean when he asks if every defense is an attack upon the court? How has Hale changed by the end of the act? Hale is stating that everyone is more fixed upon their own reputation and standing than the actual truth. He is a dynamic character because he changes from the beginning by being a leader and someone for justice to pleading with them to lie so he can do everything in his power to save those. When he calls the court out and says that everything is just an attack upon the court, he is saying that the people are trying to tell the truth and the court is not believing it. They say that witchcraft is still involved because they want to save their own reputations and they would rather have themselves than the people being accused for witchcraft standing. The quote is, "We burn a hot fire here. It melts all concealment." Danforth has belief in the court's ability to reveal the truth, and Proctor might have a little bit of the truth to what he was saying. Quote, "I think it's evidence. John, I'm an official of the court. I cannot keep it." Meaning the court can't change, and they are officials, has proven further proven that the court is wrong but can't confess to it. By the end of the act, Hale then changes to take less consideration on the witchcraft and being a witch hunter to more finding justice for the people and understanding that not everything's going to be about witchcraft, but about saving others and finding the truth in what is a lie.
Some questions and predictions that I still have about the Crucible is, first of all, my question is, when Hale just leaves the court, and why does none of the villagers try to look for him? Since, like, at the beginning of the book, he was the most trusted person on the witch topic, but now he decides to leave, not get involved in the mess. What I think is dumb, because if I was like John Proctor, I'd want him to stay, like, to confirm that I'm innocent. But now, moving on to some predictions. Personally, me, my main prediction is that the baby is in fact John Proctor's baby, since I think they did have an affair. And I'm also predicting that Rebecca Nurse might try to take the blame for being a witch, so like all the chaos that happened will just go back to normal and like neutralize, since everyone is like trusting her.
Thank you for tuning into our podcast. This is the Awesome Podcast 100 Awesome Podcast made by me, Kate, and Zack Lorichel. And see ya, boys. You know what time it is. Make sure all of you like and subscribe. Hope you enjoy.
Hey, 3, 2, 1, let's go!
Brother Kanye West.
She don't believe in shooting stars, but she believe in shoes and cars. Wood floors in the new apartment, couture from the store's departments. You more like love to start shit. I'm more of the trips to Florida, order the hors d'oeuvres, views of the water, straight from a page of your favorite author. And the weather's so breezy, man, why can't life always be this easy? She in the mirror dancing so sleazy. I get a call like, where are you, Yeezy? And try to hit you with the old wacky, till I get flashed by the paparazzi. Damn, these niggas got me. I hate these niggas more
as
than
I
not.
Recall, I know you love to show off, but I never thought that you would take it this far. What do I know?
Been a while, sweetheart, we hardly talk, I was doing my thing. I know I was fair, baby, hey, baby, lately, you've been all on my brain. And if somebody would've told me a month ago, frontin' oh, yo, I wouldn't wanna know. If somebody would've told me a year ago, it'd go get this difficult. Kinda like Katrina with no FEMA, like Martin with no Gina. Like a flight with no visa, first class with the seat back, I still see ya in my past. You on the other side of the glass of my memories museum. I'm just saying, hey, Mona Lisa.